Hi, a warm welcome to everyone. Today we are going to discuss Safe Agile. So what is Safe Agile? A scaled agile framework. So let's get started. The scaled agile framework is a system for implementing agile, lean and DevOps practices at a scale. So the scaled agile framework is the one of the most popular and booming and leading in the market and very useful when we work with Jira or Jira-LI. So we are working with Safe Agile with the organization Atlassian, which has come up with these tools Jira and Confluence or Jira-LI. So in Safe Agile, usually it carries it based on the lean principles. Okay, so they are having the methodology of agile, which take the iterative and incremental approach with a combination of DevOps, the continuous integration and continuous delivery, and lean, which will eliminate waste. So following the principle of scrum, the safe agile based on total seven layer of principle, and we have in that the core competency of lean principle is based on three level, that is your team level, program level and at portfolio level. So you have your lean portfolio management, you have your lean agile mindset, you will be having the principles what we have already gone through in agile, the extended form of that, and on a program integration planning. This plays a key role in the SAFe. Okay, so we are using SAFe with Jira and Confluence. There are multiple tools, but these are most of the popular, and it is very helpful in working at program integration level. So overall, this is a framework which includes the structure and the responsibility, how to plan and manage the work and carry the values which we have seen in Scrum, your transparency, inspection and adaption. It implies, SAFe implies the collaboration and delivery across the large number of agile team. So here you have when you get into the when you get the requirement, and in that, so before when you get the requirement, you will actually do the refinement session. So as the product owner will get the requirement in a form of epic, and it will be broken down into a multiple feature task and all, and then the scrum event will go on. In a same way, when you have a bigger project, so you are going to divide your team into the multiple teams, right? So this works on a framework for a developing and sustaining a scale product and software initiation and method, right? So it uses scrum of scrum. So it is based on Scrum as a building block, and then it moves forward, right? So you have all your events, role, artifacts and rules that will bind them together, all the team, right? So let's take an example. We are having a product of CT scanner machine that is comes under healthcare domain, right? So this is in CT scanner machine, this is in our portfolio layer. Now when you have got the requirement from the client, the requirement is huge, and you have divided your team into multiple teams, right? So how you have divided your team into a multiple user story, and each team will having follow their scrum, which consists of your role, event, artifacts and rule that bind and wave together and work appropriately with them. So usually 3 to 9 scrum team working on a single product backlog item, and the thumb rule will be same: one product backlog, one product owner, and one increment, right? So multiple team work together, they have the definition of done will be get integrated, and the increment will be same to meet the goal, and depend there should not be any dependency. So this is how it works. So when you have got the CT scanner machine, that is on your portfolio layer. When you have got when you have divided your CT scanner product, the software, what you need to reach to particular goal, you have made a different milestone. So what you did, you have made a particular module, say you have made some 5 module, okay? Each 5 module is taken care by each scrum team. That is your program level, okay? You have to keep a track on a structure board of this program integrated level. When you are working on, one team is working on a scrum, and they will be keeping a track on this work on a scrum board, right? If it is based on Kanban board, it will go on Kanban board. And you are going to, as a scrum master, you are going to track as a product owner, either a product owner or a scrum master or a scrum team going to keep a track on this program level, team level, and definitely on each and every step, and if there is any impediments and blocker. So you are going to keep a track. So the product owner will concentrate to maximize the value of the product and the backlog. It will keep ownership to manage the backlog on each module, and there should not be any conflict. So we are having one product owner. Now the scrum master will keep a track. There are two possibilities. Either a one scrum master can take care for few teams, multiple teams, or every team can have each scrum master. So both possibilities are possible. Only the thing, product owner should be same and one single source of product backlog, right? So each scrum master is going to keep a track on team level. On a program level, you as a scrum team or as a product owner, you are going to keep a track on program integration level and on portfolio level, right? So in portfolio, what all programs is running out? You have 5 program integrated running out. That is your 5 module of CT scanner, right? So your CT scanner is portfolio. Your each module is your program level, and each team, each module, they are following the scrum, that is your team level. So that's why it is called scrum of scrum. It is also called, scrum of scrum is also called a Nexus framework, right? So here I have shown that pre-sprint activities. So each sprint, each module, each team, what they will do? They will go with the grooming session. They will estimate all the requirement. They will break down their user story into a small feature and task and subtask. They will keep ready their DOR, definition of ready, all the user story which is going to go for the sprint planning for the particular sprint and sprint goal, right? Then after that, each scrum team are going to work on this, their pre-sprint activities, their refinement and grooming session, that will contain your estimation, that is your sizing, put a based on your work, based on your effort, how many days you are going to take, based on the complexity, based on the uncertainty, you are going to estimate your user story with a relative point story. Once you are done with that, your scrum master will keep a track on your capacity and then your estimated story point and then your velocity. As the sprint will go on, with few sprint, we will get a sustainable pace based on the velocity, right? So each sprint will go with that. every sprint is having can have same length, can have different length. So for their definition of done, every scrum team can have their stringent strict criteria, but in a nutshell, the definition of done, that should be integrated to the same increment, right? And there should not be any dependency that the other team will not able to fulfill on the sprint goal, or they will be lacking behind on the commitment side, right? So your pre-sprint activities for all the teams at a program level, and again your sprint activities on this. Let me show you. Okay, so we will see the diagram in the upcoming slide, and we are keeping a track with our Atlassian tool, that is your Jira, and Jira is formally known as has come up in 2002, and it is in their market, but we have Jira Align, which was actually acquired by Atlassian only in early 2019. So it is a cloud-based product that connect securely to one or more instances like the server or data center to give insight into the state of play for all the team in an enterprise level or a program level. Okay, so this is new to the, not actually new, but it is booming in the market. It is using, and in Jira also you can go to my YouTube channel, and recently I have uploaded a video, Jira in Scrum of Scrum. So there in Jira we can keep a track on multiple Scrum team when it is working, and you are having your Confluence where you can collaborate, you can save the document, you can interact, you can set up the meeting, and there are multiple uses on that. So Scrum with Jira, you can set up that Kanban with Jira, you can set up the board. So you need to get install the Jira or Jira Align, anyone. Based on that, you will get an option to choose the board. In that, you can choose the board, like whether you are using Jira for a bug tracking or a project management, and which board your project is based on, Scrum or Kanban. So based on that, you can do, you can go with your start of your sprint, create a sprint, and you'll be having your epic and the backlog creation in that, dividing your work into multiple user story. You will drag your work into the particular sprint, you will start your sprint, and you will keep a track, monitor your work in your board, Scrum board or Kanban board, and based on that you will take care for your reporting. You will go with your sprint capacity of each sprint, and you can keep a track on your sustainable pace and the velocity. You will get, you can whoever are there in the team, you can provide an access, and everyone, and this will get updated. If you can choose in every 10 minute or every 15 minute or every hour, based on completion of your work, your reporting, your matrices is going to be updated, and everyone can keep a track on that, your burn down, your sprint report, your epic report, your velocity report, burned on everything, right? So these are the features. Now, yeah, essential, safe. So here we are, where we are carrying the safe agile, and which carries the principle that is safe is based on 10 fundamental concept which has been evolved from agile principle, that is your same customer satisfaction, agility, fast delivery, self-organized team, and you can have more than a process oriented or a tool oriented, the people can interact, the interaction and collaboration is instant, and people are productive, flexible, and more than the documentation, they concentrate on the tool and the good software, and they build a relationship with the customer. Not only they will rely on the mailing and the contract negotiation with the legal people, and then they are ready. They are just not following the plan. They are actually getting into that and executing their work with the fastest and continuous delivery and the integration and the delivery. You have implementation, and it is based on the lean principle and agile portfolio. Operation side and the software side coordinate together your business people, that is your agile, your operation product people, that is your DevOps, and your technology people, that's your team. So all work together, that is your lean agile mindset. Okay, so we will go in the detail. So this is a Venn diagram where you can see that you have DevOps team at a program level, right? You have a team where you are going to do the deployment, right? And you have a multiple epic at program integrated objective. You have two, that Kanban board is there, and then a Scrum board is there, and you have your development team, you have a product owner, you have a Scrum master, that is your agile team. So this is based on the principle which we have seen in the Scrum and the Nexus framework, that it is at the enterprise level, right? And you have the team, the role will be product owner, Scrum master, and developers, that is the development team. There will be no discrimination who's from operation side, who's from testing side, and you have a Scrum master, you have a product owner. You are going with all the events, that is your under sprint, that will be for your 1 month or less than that. We have two kind of application. One is custom application and one is package application. So when we are working on custom application, we go for 2 to 4 weeks. When we go for a package application, we go for 3 to 5 weeks. So your custom application are the shorter project, and your package application usually work for the larger project. Like you have Workday, you have SAP, you have SFDC, Salesforce, etc., etc. And for a custom application, multiple teams will be there. We have already taken an example of CT scanner machine, right? So that is your custom application, and you have a multiple module, multiple Scrum team going with all the process under the sprint. You have all the events, your sprint planning, your daily Scrum, your sprint review, and your sprint retrospective. Okay, now when you are having this, after that, based on the retrospective, you are adapting your definition of done, and you are looking how your last sprint went on basis of people, processes, tool, individual, and interaction, and you are adapting that definition of done and most of the improvement in that, and you are giving the potentially releasable, usable product, that is your DoD, and in every release or every deployment, I should say, so your each version will complement your previous version. So when a developer will write the code, build any application, he will check in on the internal tool. The team will review. It is a self-organized team, creative people, flexible people, and productive people. So they will review how it is working, how good is there, any bug is there, and based on that, they will check out the thing. It will go on the deployment, right? And then when it go on the deployment, every sprint will have at least one deployment. At least one deployment, and release, when we have to release, that will be taken care by product owner in the sprint review meeting. It will be there will be interaction with the stakeholder, and the product owner will look into the business condition, look into the market strategy and research, and then he will confirm when the application have to get released. right? So based on that, if there is before we go into the release, if there is any breakdown of the code or if you have any defect has come up, that will be taken care before only, right? And now once we are doing this in every sprint, so each team will follow this. Each team will give their DoD and that will get integrated, and you will be having, you are going to reach your product goal. So when all your product backlog will get completed, then your increment will get born, right? So in the same way, you have to go, and when you are keeping a track on all the module in all the EPIC, that is your PI planning, and at a program level, that is your program level, and you are going to keep a track. So when actually we keep a track on that, so on a management side, so before only they will set a strategy how to go with this management. They will build that strategy pyramid that will be value driven, not only the, so traditional method was plan driven, and now in agile and save, it is a value driven. They will rank the theme in that theme is your EPIC at a program level. They will rank the theme and they will intake and compare those EPIC and their values, and then accordingly they will put on the release and they will go with the outcome with the customer. That is overall called your portfolio backlog management, and based on that you will be having your goal balancing report that will be visible with everyone, and it will be based on continuous delivery pipeline, that is your continuous integration and delivery. So your iteration will contain all the stages, that is a design, development, testing, deployment, maintenance, everything. So everywhere it will be a continuous, and it will go with the continuous feedback loop. So based on the feedback you are improvised, every sprint will be a lesson learned, it will go further, right? So see, you have a PI objective, you have an enabler, you have a story, you have feature, and you're keeping a track, and then you are giving the product to the solution with the customer. Okay, so let's talk on the challenges and the dependency which we get on daily basis. So what happened when multiple team are working collectively, so the difficulty and the challenges arise based on the requirement, based on the domain knowledge, based on the software side. It can be any dependency, and we need to ensure that dependency should not be there. So how this SAFe came into the picture, right? So this software delivery and integration was working on artifacts and activities on a sprint and scrum. So when you have bigger, multiple people are there, and you are dividing your work into different program, multiple program, then one scrum team is working on same product backlog and in the same code base for the product, and the other team is also working. So if the developer are not collated or working, means he is not aware or she is aware that how will they communicate when they are doing work, right? So that will affect each other, then the dependency arises. So if they work on different team, how will they integrate their work? How will they test the integrated increment? These challenges appears when two or more than one scrum team are working on a single increment. So they are on a practical basis, there are many dependencies, and that's why the SAFe and lean principle are there, Nexus framework are there, where the scope of the requirement should not get overlap. So the scrum team, the developers will pull the work from the product backlog. They will pull the work from the product backlog. The knowledge they should have on ordering or estimating or keeping their DOR that they will take care individually, right? So they are going to have a entire domain knowledge. So if the example we have taken, so all the scrum team, all five scrum team should have the domain knowledge on what domain, healthcare domain they are working, what is their product, that is CT scanner, what exactly based on, what are the business and market for that business value and market strategy from them. That knowledge will be given by the product owner or scrum master, right? So anybody can give, as per scrum guide, the product owner is liable to keep the thing transparent, but we have a scrum master to ensure that your backlog is transparent and it is understandable by everyone. Again, so all the module are using different software or process, or so they should be aware that what all requirements are there, how they have initiated in the software and how their DoD is correlated and working on that, right? So in SAFe we have this process framework for multiple scrum team working together to create an integrated increment. So your nexus is consistent with Scrum and it's a part with the familiar to those who have used Scrum. It is based on the Nexus framework only, right? The difference is only when you are using the Nexus framework, so you are keeping a track on a program level and only looking on the you mean to say software delivery side, and when you are looking into a SAFe Agile side, you are also keeping a track of your cost of ownership. That is how much your budgeting part, how much cost you have been giving on each epic, and what is the final outcome for that, what is the expectation for that, and what is the actual value, and what was the projected one. So like that, in SAFe you are going to work on the budgeting side also. Okay, so let's move on the next slide, program level. So here when you go to the program level, so each module will be having the role. That role will be of scrum master, product owner, and the team member, development team. So all will everyone will self-organize, and they are having their sprint backlog. Each scrum will have their own sprint backlog, and their so they have overall the product backlog will be same. So your artifacts contain your single product backlog, all scrum team have their sprint backlog, and they have a single increment, that is your DoD, potentially releasable usable product, right? So all scrum team use the same single product backlog, and as the product backlog item are refined and made ready, and that will indicate which team will do the work inside the sprint and will be transparent. So a new artifacts, that is your everyone will be having their new artifact, that is your sprint backlog, right? So all the team will be having the existing sprint backlog and transparency within the team, and all scrum team maintain their individual sprint backlog and keeping a track on daily scrum, and the final increment will be the same. Now the event will be, so event are appended to placed around, and it will be a regular scrum event everywhere, and in a duration the all scrum team one or two POC or representative, they will sync up with each other and they will overall look into the effort of all scrum team and each individual team as well. So the overall workflow will be multiple cross-functional scrum team will be working together and working on the delivery, that is a potentially releasable integrated increment. So at least by end of each sprint, the POC, the point of contact, the who is going to represent a team, a particular scrum team, they will sync up and they will discuss. So they will look based on the dependency if team everything is going fine or is there any impediment or blocker on any uncertainty or risk area. So you have this new and you are have new epic has been broken down into the feature and task and subtask. You are ready with your program increment. So multiple scrum team is ready. They have went with the refinement of product backlog and they have chosen all their work. So everyone knows that what work and what product backlog they have taken and how it is related. And then they have their separate sprint backlog and they will get into the designing, development, testing and the DoD, right? So they have all their, they will keep a track on the Scrum or Kanban board, whatever board they use, and they will look into the keep tracking in all the events like sprint planning, your daily Scrum, your review meeting and your retrospective. And then they will, so let's go like in all events. So once the product backlog is decomposed, they will look into the dependency. Now they have got that sprint backlog in every sprint. They will do the refinement and they will get into the sprint planning. So each Scrum team meet to discuss and review the refined product backlog. So we have discussed on a team level till now that in team level, they will discuss on each event. Now on a program level, each team will either full team or a representative, it will be vary organization to organization how they have made a setup. So each Scrum team will discuss and review the define the product backlog together, right? So first they have a together and then they have a separate sprint planning in each Scrum. So in starting on a program level, each Scrum team will be meet up same place and same time to reduce the complexity and they will refine the product backlog. The selected product backlog item for each team, each Scrum team then plan their own sprint, right? Once they get their product backlog, they will plan their own sprint interacting with each other team and the outcome will be set as a sprint goal. So that will be taken care by the individual Scrum and everybody will be having that. Now on a development work, all the team frequently integrate their work into a common environment and that can be tested to ensure that integration is done. So this is important because now you have just divided the requirement and on a program level, you have multiple things is running out, but when you are doing the integrated testing, you will get to know that overall product, how it is working. So each module is working fine. And then we are meeting up. Then you are looking, okay, this is also working fine. That is your daily Scrum. So actually it is daily Scrum, but practically we often meet and look into that daily work that appropriate representative for each team meet daily to identify if any integration or issue exists. If identify this information is transferred back to the each Scrum team daily transferred to the daily Scrum and the Scrum team then use their daily Scrum to create a plan for a long day and be ensured that the integration issue whatever has been raised that should be taken care and that should be noted in that impediments or blocker, and that should be resolved at the earliest. So you have now, as together you have done, you are done with your planning, and individually you have taken care of your own work, and then you are meeting daily to whether your all work means all your module are working together, and after testing how it is working fine or not, and based on the impediment, you based on the risk, you are going to make a mitigation plan. Then finally, the second last event will be your sprint review on a program level, and your sprint review is held at the second last event to provide the feedback on integrated increment that you have built over the sprint. Right, so over the sprint, together all the individual from the Scrum team along with the stakeholder review this integrated increment, and they do this adjustment. If there is anything, any user story or backlog is left, that will be get transferred to the product backlog. In all the team, whatever sprint backlog will be left, it will go again to the product backlog. The product owner will prioritize and do the ordering, and then it will be pulled by the individual team and the developers. So in sprint review, so together it will be seen how the outcome is coming, and based on that they will move further. And the last event will be your on a program level, your sprint retrospective. So in this Scrum team, okay, so appropriate again here, the once you all you have met in the review meeting, so appropriate representative from each Scrum team meet to identify and share the challenges, and then each Scrum team hold the individual sprint retrospective, and appropriate representative from each team again meet to discuss if any action is needed based on the shared challenges to provide bottom up intelligence. So they will look that if the maximum improvement what can be taken, and they will adapt the definition of done together, and then accordingly each representative will inform the team, and they will again work. So this overall, the role, event and artifact inherited the purpose and intent attribute of the corresponding Scrum role, event and all the rules, right? So this is all about your program level, and when your all the increment your product backlog will get completed, then you will get into the done stage, and you will get your product goal, that is your increment will get born. Now when you are here, so when you are at this stage, then you must have looked all functional and non-functional requirement together, comparing in all the program level. All the module has been developed, tested properly, and non-functional part, the performance and the security, which will be a part of backlog and the definition of done. So at program level, when you have achieved, then on a team level you have achieved, then a program level you have achieved, and on a portfolio level that will be achieved. So team level we have just discussed, like, so on a program level each individual will meet and come up with the final increment. On now on a team level, you have the role of the product owner, the scrum master and the development team, and the which is called as a developer. And then you have you are going to keep a track, right? So your product owner will be going to keep a track in all the teams, right? All the integration team, the scrum master can have the overall responsibility to ensure that all team are dependencies are not lie, and this framework is Scrum framework is understood, this safe and Scrum and Nexus is understood by everyone, and the Scrum master may also be Scrum master in one or more than Scrum team. So that can definitely happen. So it will be depend, and the product owner is accountable for managing the product backlog so that maximize the value is delivered from an integrated increment created by all the team and individual team, and how this will be so how this is done and it can it might vary from organization to organization and team to team, but the product owner will be a single person, so that there will be no glitches will come based on the requirement. So if you have a single source of product backlog and a single product owner, and the product owner will responsible for maximizing the value of product, and your increment will be one, right? And the team member, you have you can say it as a safe team member or Nexus integration team member, the development team. So this will this particular team will consist of professional who are skilled in the tool, various practice and the system engineering. They will be cross-functional, so whatever skill is required to build this product, so all skill will be available, and based on the change in the scope or requirement, they will be a quick adapter, and they have that agility to upgrade themselves and learn quickly and apply quickly on that. So the team member will responsible for coaching and guiding each other, and they will implement and they will reach the milestone. The Scrum Master will take care that all the events, meetings, he will facilitate that are productive and positive. He will look that your backlog is transparent, understandable by everyone, and it is there should not be any dependency. All team member will have all the values, your commitment, focus, courage, openness and respect. Your team member are vocal and flexible. They have that agility to take up. He has to establish the scrum within a team and within the organization. The scrum master will sync up with the product owner and look that on the management of the product backlog in ordering. He or she will participate and maximizing the value. He will assist and facilitate the way product owner need, and also take care based on again organization to organization on the budgeting and costing. If there is any impediment and blocker will come to the scrum team, the scrum master is going to own that and resolve that. So in a nutshell, scrum master is a true leader, and it will take the team in a value driven way. Okay, so in a team level, again you have all the events which we have just discussed, and all the events are time boxed event. So you have your sprint planning. Your overall sprint should be 1 month or less than that. Your sprint planning will be 8 hours and less than that, maximum of 8 hours. Your daily scrum will be for 15 minutes. Your sprint review will be maximum of 4 hours. And your sprint retrospective will be maximum of 3 hours. So all event will take place in the same place, and to avoid the complexity. So before, retrospective was something like a informal kind of meeting, but now it is a formal meeting and it also take place on the same place. Now, yeah, so in so all the event, so you have when you are done with all your process, so it is very important, and challenges come arise usually on a refinement and whether you have done your estimation properly or not. Because if you have really done your estimation, if your grooming and refinement session and went well, then your challenges might come less. and what commitment the team is going to do, they are going to reach on that commitment. So refinement of that product backlog at a scale server dual purpose. So it helps the Scrum team to forecast which team will deliver which product backlog item, and it identify the dependency across those items. And the transparency allow the team to monitor and minimize the dependency. So the refinement of the product backlog item in this safe agile scaled agile framework continue until the product backlog item are sufficiently independent to be worked on a single Scrum team without excessive conflict. So the number, frequency, duration and attendance of refinement is based on the dependency and uncertainty inherent in the product backlog. The product backlog item pass through different level of decomposition from very large and actionable work that single Scrum team could deliver inside a sprint at a team level. Now your refinement is continuous throughout the sprint as necessary and appropriate. It can happen anytime, and the refinement and grooming session will not count in the event. So your product backlog refinement will continue within each team in order for the product backlog item to be ready for the selection of the next sprint planning event. So when you're there will be no gap in any of the sprint in any of the team, and when your current sprint is going to be end, that time only the product owner and the developer will collaborate together, and product owner can use the 10% of capacity and work on the next sprint planning event. So there will be no gap in any of the sprint, in any of the sprint and in any of the module. And each particular in each sprint you have your duration, and the other module sprint, so the sprint duration can vary. So for example, you have sprint one of CT scanner machine, you have one module say cardiac function module, and your other module is a brain module. So might be in sprint one this can be of 2 weeks, and in the brain it can be of 3 weeks. That possibilities are there. Usually they keep sync, but there is no restriction on that. So yeah, so overall the team ensure at a team level that you are going smooth with your refinement, your sprint planning, and then you are setting up your sprint goal, your backlog. What is your sprint backlog? Your sprint backlog contain your sprint goal, which is created by entire Scrum team, and the forecast and PBI. So your PBIs is the product backlog item pulled by the developers, your sprint goal set by the Scrum team, and how that PBIs will get implemented, that forecast is your sprint backlog, right? So so this will be taken care of, the increment that DoD will be the increment will be taken care by developers. The DoD will be taken, it is the standard set by the organization and minimum at a Scrum team level, and which will be the increment will be taken care by the developer. And the increment, that is a potentially releasable product, that will be the entire Scrum team will be going to take care. Your daily Scrum will be there at a team level, and you are going to track your sprint sprint goal if there is any impediment, and you will update your sprint backlog. So if you have any blocker, anything, that will be taken care on the daily basis. And once that is done, you are going to, you know, test all your feature. You will do check-in, you will do check-in your code, it will be reviewed, and then test, all the testing will be done. And then it will be check out and go into the deployment. And if any bug will come, any defect will come, so after production, after deployment, if any error is coming, that is called as defect. And in the development, if something is happening, that is called your bug. So that defect will be taken care, and that will be fixed, and that will be get released, right? So you are reaching with your once you are giving the deployment, again it will go to the production, and in each epic your version field will be there, that will be get tagged, and each version will complement the previous version and you will reach to your done step, right? So you will look into the outcome in the sprint review meeting, that what all things you have captured, outcome in a completed a backlog only. Whatever will be not completed, it will be go into the backlog. So you will have a review with your stakeholder, and it will be capturing the feedback from the stakeholder and the product owner. So sprint review is not a any kind of restriction that you have to show the outcome. If you are able to complete before that, there will be interaction all the time with the stakeholder, with the entire scrum team, and this can be, the outcome can be shown before also, and they will just meet up in the sprint review meeting. If they have completed all the backlog before ending the sprint is not going to complete early. It will complete on time, which has been fixed, and the developer can pull the PBIs from the product backlog, and they can work to achieve that goal. Then in retrospective, that will be a formal opportunity to inspect and adapt itself and create a plan for improvement to be enacted during the next sprint to ensure the continuous improvement. So it consists of usually three part. So let's have a quick walkthrough on that. So the first part is an opportunity for appropriate representative from across the scrum of a scrum team and identify the issue that you are going to identify the issue that if that is impacting the team or a product or a application and any dependency as a single team, right? So we have seen at program level, we have seen a team level. So as a single team and a portfolio level, as a portfolio level as a single team, if there is anything which is impacting the team, and the purpose is to make a shared issue and transparency to all the team so that they will get to know and give up, means come up with the plan and a quick solution, okay, before a release, before we go into the release. For release we use Jira tool and we look into this parameter, right? So the second part consists of each team holding their own sprint retrospective as a described in the scrum framework, and they can use issues raised from the first part of the scrum of scrum retrospective as an input for the team discussion, right? What most of the improvement you have taken care. So the individual scrum team should action to address on these issues during the individual scrum team retrospective, and overall also as a scrum of a scrum, it will be taken care. And the final and third is the opportunity for appropriate representative for the scrum team to meet again and agree on how to visualize and track the identified action, and this will allow the done and integrated increment as a whole to adapt the definition of done. So at an individual as a first we have seen together all the team has taken up, then again individually they have applied, then again together how as a whole it is impacting and making up. So this is the usually scaling and the agile team and going into that. So now sometimes the challenges arise that de-scoping is happening, or a common scaling die functions in every retrospective will address these kind of challenges. So was any work left undone? If the whatever the commitment has been done, is commitment has been done properly, means whether they are on the commitment or they are over committed or they are lacking on the commitment. So did as what all as a team individual at a team level and as a team at a program level, what all the technical depths, so where all the artifacts, particularly code, all the your application document has been successfully integrated or not, code has been integrated or not. So was this software built and tested properly and deployed, and has enough space to prevent of overwhelming accumulation to this unresolved dependency. So these things will be taken care in the retrospective, and that will be the maximum improvement with the mitigation plan that will be are going to adapt in the next sprint. So based on that, they are going to look how your sprint has happened all together at team level and a program level, or what all the issue was there, a technical debt or a individual level or your artifact level. So what was the undone and how it has been correction we have done and we have prevented, right? So these things we are going to take care, and based on that we are going to give release. We will keep a track on progress of release each version, and that should complement your next version. The continuous feedback loop will be there, and this will show the program how smoothly it is going forward, right? And you will be having your sprint matrices, right? How you will see that how your overall sprint went off. Then you have your epic burn down chart, sprint burn down chart and epic burn down chart. So this is the release burn down for a particular version. You will be having at sprint level, you will be having at epic level, at a program level. So you will keep a track that the remaining work, you will be having the other matrices of burn up, that what is the completed work, what has been added, what is remaining, right? So you will be having your epic report, you will be having your sprint report, you will be having a burn down chart, you will be having your burn up chart, you will be having your capacity chart versus the velocity chart, what was the defect leakage will be there, and what are outcome or gain you have achieved, and what is the success story on that, and based on that a sustainable pace, right? So your team is working, say your sprint one, your team story point was 40, that is your velocity, and then you have 32, and then you have 31, again you went up 38, and again you went up with 32 or 33. So like that, when you project your velocity also, it will become something around, you know, if it is coming on 30s, then it will come on that, and that will be your sustainable pace. So multiple matrices and chart which can be tracked in every 15 minute, every 10 minute, on a daily basis, hourly basis, and it can be circulated entire team, and your status of the work will be monitored in your scrum board, in your structure board at a program level, in your epic level, in your theme level, and when you use the Kanban board, then you use this cumulative flow diagram. So where it works on the WIP limit, your entry and exit point, and your work in progress for usually or to keep a track on the project they worked on, set that limit that, you know, you can take more, cannot take more than 10 ticket or like that, and if you put then it will not accept, right? So like that you will set a limit and you will work with the flow to execute your work in the Kanban, and with the, it will be showcased in your cumulative flow diagram, right? It will be based on your, here in we use in a scrum board, here we have visualization board in a Kanban. Okay, so agile matrices and Excel tracker. Okay, so see, you have your matrices based on, now we will talk on the budgeting side. So your total number of estimation, based on that, right, you are having your budget versus your estimation has been done, and based on your wages, what was the actual cost, right? So what was the actual cost, what changes has been done on a scope level, overall what was the environment on that, on the your user stories, and what productivity and a sustainable pace you have given, and overall what was the quality. So there will be no compromise on the quality, and the allocation will be done on the you know, all the this matrices, the core matrices or the optional, but overall nutshell we will talk, the allocation will be go on the budget estimate and the actual value. That will be based on these parameter, right? Your productivity, your cost, your scope and your agile health. So in your quality, what was the defect, leakage was there. So for example, you are going with the productivity, you are doing the testing, and more if something is come up good at more than 90-95%, that will be come as a green layer. So here in agile matrices we follow on RAG matrices. R is red, A is amber and G is green. So when you are having your anything, say anything you have more than 90, more than 90%, your defect leakage will be, means defect leakage in the sense your product, there is no defect on that, and everything you're giving the code on the deployment and everything more than 90%, that will go on a green, right? So that will be go on a green. Okay, so this will be your green. Okay, if something will say defect leakage, say you are having something and that is come up, something is less, means between 70-80%, right? So 70-80% range, right? So it, what will be that? That you can say you will be come on an amber color. So this matrices will go to your leadership and you have to tell, okay, this will come on an amber color, and in your Excel, which is based on macros, or if you are using any report by Power BI, so you have to show in RAG status, this is your green, this is your amber, and then you are having something. Definitely if something is coming less than 70%, that will be your anything 69 and less than that, that will be your red, that will be your red color, right? So it will not come up now. Okay, so red, yeah, so this will be your red color, right? So this will be your red color. Now for example, you are having a team, right? You are having a team, and you have, say, you know, your defect leakage of 5 is restored on this, you have something on this, and you have something on, you know, this. So based on this matrices you will make the plan and you will move further. So based on your productivity, yeah, you will look your sustainable pace, right? You will look at your velocity, you will look at how you are doing the code coverage and test automation coverage you are going to give, what is your actual stories you have committed, and how much you are giving. So your estimation versus actual, so what you have committed, what you have estimated, what actually you have given. So your expected value versus actual value, so that will be go on that. And then again, cost will be something which we discuss based on your you know, development, your testing area, that is called your total cost of ownership, based on your epic stories, you know, all the points that will be come on that cost, and what scope, any changes has been added or anything has been taken off. So what was the changes on the scope, right? So what all the changes you have done on the scope side, so whether descoping has been done or scope has been done. So your program increment level or a team level, so that will be this thing. Overall, what was the health, right? What was the uncertainty has come up, what the mitigation plan you have given, what impediment and risk has come up in each sprint, what was the technical depth which we discuss, right? So your cost, based on your total cost of ownership, you are going to work on the cost of rework. That is, that will be your actually the cone of uncertainty, where you are having a cone and this is your business value, and this is your technology value. And in the starting, things will be less known, and as they will involve, the uncertainty will become reduced, right? So this will be taken care. So this matrices will be on program increments and sprint level, where you have program increment, all the increment name will be there, what was the start date, what was the end date, what all themes and program has gone through, right? So what was the on a team level, what all things has went, and what was the version has been linked. So this is one of the important, and if it is as it is transparent inspection based on that, the frequent inspection, and as more as based on the inspection, the team will adapt, the more agility it will be gone. And actually the scale agile framework has came into the picture, because to run this show on a value driven way only, so they have to be focused and move forward in a frequent way. Okay, so Jira advanced search. So how to use Jira? Okay, so this is something, let me take you through with. So when you are using the Jira as a scrum master, and when you are searching for any issue or a user story, and when you are into a sprint capacity planning and agile portfolio management, so you can go with this JQL search, that is your advanced search in Jira, to search for an issue, right? So the basic search is more precise than the quick search, and if you know the query, then this will make it easier to use this advanced search. So it provide a user friendly interface that let you define the complex queries without needing to know how to use, you know, JSQL advanced searching. So to use the basic search, navigate the issue into the header. So what you can do, you can just navigate the issue in the header and search for that issue as per your criteria, or you can use the jQuery, right? So you can write the project name, team, the issue type, and based on that you can create on a program level, yeah, epic link, whatever is available. So this is used by the scrum master to set up the agile board or search portfolio management, and jQuery is used to search for the issues. Okay, now team level hierarchy. Okay, so yeah, here is the same. So we have seen, right? So you have overall the agile team, right? So who all are there in agile team? That will be on a portfolio level. So we have taken an example of CT scanner. So your agile team will be based on all the combination of all the program and all the team. Your scrum team one, that is working on one module, right? So again, when you go with the different events, it will go like that, the hierarchy. So it will overall, the first level will be at a portfolio level, then you have your program level, and then you have your team level. So each team will having what all, you know, role, and then the event, and then the artifacts. Then as a program level, what all themes epic we have, what all events we have gone through, and what all roles we have seen, right? So roles same, product owner will be one, single source product backlog, but scrum master can be part into one or more than that. That will be your, you have seen your now your agile and lean principle is based on your program layer, and then program integration. So you, when you are working on different model, that is program layer is nothing but a program integration level. So your portfolio layer, program layer, and team layer. Okay, so you can keep a track on sprint status. We have just discussed in the last third slide the RAG status, right? So So you have a green that is going smooth. Green is something you are on a good note, right? And that will be count as a done stage. You have done, you have completed something that is your green color, right? And if you are in work in progress, that will be your amber color, right? So your work in progress is your amber color, and which is on a risk area, that will be your red color. So you will take your actual estimated and expected value based on what kind of matrices you are working, and when you project your report to the line of business, you can show in a RAG status and you can keep a track on that. So you will look into that. So in a sprint level, right? So first you will look into the sprint, each sprint has reached to the sprint goal, and when multiple sprint will work together, that will reach to your product goal. And then multiple scrum team are there, and each scrum team is working on a reaching on a sprint goal, and all sprint goal is reaching to the product goal, and your product goal is your integration is one. Your integration is one where you are reaching, then you are, when all backlog is completed, you are getting your result, right? You're reaching your goal, your vision. If anything has come up, the uncertainty all, you are dealing with that, and based on that you can showcase the reporting on a sprint status, on a team level, program level, and a portfolio level. So how to structure the program level space in Confluence? Okay, so this you can look into that when you will be working on a Confluence. So you will be having, let me take you through in a concise way. So you need to go with the Jira integration setup and Confluence setup, and when you Google it, you have to write it Jira download or integration setup. You will get Jira software, you will get Jira services, you will get Confluence. Once you are done with your setup, you will choose the board and you will set up with the project, and on a team level you will be go with the sprint, and a program level you will go with on a roadmap tab, and in that you will be having multiple epic will be there. So I have given this video in my YouTube channel. You can definitely I'll recommend you to go through that. If you want a detailed description there, that will be going to be really helpful. Then in your roadmap, when you have multiple things, multiple epic, then you have your program increment. You can keep a track. You have to give the start and end date and the description on the program, right? And in that you can keep a track on the whatever program planning you are doing, and you can keep a track on each epic, and that is your theme. What the you can provide the access in the project setting, and if you need to add any column in your scrum board or each sprint board or in this structure board, so based on that there will be a plus sign, and you can, based on your uses in the team and organization, you can increase your column based on that, how you want to track the status. So you can set up your status in the to-do list, in the work in progress, in the done stage, in the review stage, in the testing on a bug, testing on a defect. Multiple column should be there to take a status, and in that the reporting what you are going to build, right? And who all are team member based on your capacity on a team level, and then program level, and who all are working on what, right? What are the project ID they have been tagged. So each team, the number of resources, and what all how many user story they have taken, what is the story point, and what they are working, and the velocity, that will be a team level. When you are working on governance status on a program level, then you have number of all the employee with the project ID, what project ID they have been tagged, what are module they are working, what is their velocity, and what Is there any risk? Is there coming uncertainty is coming, and how they are working and giving the outcome to the client or the organization. That will be your all governance station will be captured, and there will be a connect frequently on a weekly basis, where we will go to all the module. Governance status will go with all the, like we have taken this example city scan, so we'll go with all the 5 module to look into that, all the ceremonies, how it went well, the matrices, what we discussed, the program increment, all the themes, right? So if any uncertainty, what log or issue has been raised, what overall the architecture, how the team has been integrated, and whether our product is working and testable properly, and what is the performance, and is there, I mean, how it is working on a continuous feedback loop, continuous integration and delivery, that will be your DevOps. And the deployment, like you check in and check out on the time of each sprint and on what range you are giving the release, right? So overall, or your product management and the key process and the resources, you are going to keep a track on that. And budgeting side, if we need to talk, so the structure, what we will, so here on a software application side, we use the Confluence and Jira, and software, Jira software and Confluence. And when budgeting and costing, we will also use in program and project management and portfolio management, the Jira Align, where you look how you have estimated, what is the actual budget and what you have expected and what you have projected. So based on that, you are going to keep a track. Yeah, so this is what we discussed, the program level hierarchy. We just spoke that how we are going to work on each level, and we will keep a track on that. We just discussed, it is the same on a team level we did, and again on a program level we did. Same governance status, next sprint we have already gone through and we just discussed. So Confluence, yeah, it is something that you can create and edit the page. You can, there will be a link. You can actually, when you're working on Jira and all your project, you can link. There will be a page, there will be something on a page connection, and that will link all your work, and it will be give you a good repository to go on that, and the reporting, set up the meeting and the area. So the multiple plugins are recommended. Yeah, so if you install Jira, so you might not have the plugin, say, Zephyr for bug tracking, or Slack, and it was there for your, GitHub and Jenkins and all, you do the deployment, right? So you have some plugin, Zyra and Slack, so you can work on the deployment initiation. And then sprint capacity. So multiple plugins are there. You can look into that. The matrices and reports are there. Bubble chart are there. So many things are there. So when you explore, you will get any good look into that. So I have also a detailed video on Jira and Confluence. So you can definitely, I'll recommend you to go through that. Okay. So yeah, as I said, you can initiate for the meeting, right? In Confluence, it is very good to keep a track on all your notes, all your document, sync up with your team and set up for the meeting, and task and keeping a track and a status. So